Hey guys, and welcome again to the Oath of Oblige. This time,
yay! Random generated shit pods.
Yeah, and barrels.
Oh, barrels are good, I guess.
And skulls.
So yeah, this is. Let me see the name. 69420.1. Thanks to Isa, I already chan for this. That's a pretty good combination of one name and poster name.
Yeah.
I actually played this a long time ago, but just forgetting to, you know, uncut it and stuff.
Yeah, he's been busy.
Yeah, you should update your friend Vales.
You should get to Legacy of Sovereign 2.
So I see some strange effects going on here.
Ooh, what could it be?
Are you using some? Yeah.
Yeah, just like in the other Oblige video, I'm using Redoom. So Redoom is made by another goon called the Kins. And change effects, blood, gives, walking sound, sometimes different.
Is this the one with the ludicrous gives?
Yes. And we'll be seeing ludicrous gives at least once, I'm sure of that. I remember seeing once.
Awesome.
That's excellent. Yes. That's the best part of the world.
Yes.
Well, I like the fluid sprites, so that's good.
Fluid sprites. Oh.
Well, actually, yeah, the mod as well includes the sound and the sprites made from Per Christian, I think. That's the guy who made the new sprites for weapons. And I really like them. Before, I only used them, but now since this mod bundles them, why not?
Can you stop camping in this corridor, please?
Yeah, I'm going up just right now. So, yeah, this is obviously on fast and. This is not bad, except for this part here. Just this big open room here is pain in the ass with imp shotgunners and barrels everywhere. After that, don't worry, it's going to be much smaller.
Good.
And the maps are kind of interesting. You see, there's pits everywhere, barrels everywhere, and a big profusion of lost souls, pain elementals, half-rise. We'll be seeing that in the maps. And that was.
Yes. Beautiful.
Excellent.
Pretty. It's. That's a nice game. I'm still savoring the game.
Yes. Keeps always good. Blood and alternate death animation.
Yeah.
Yep.
And that will be the last Oblige you've deck, because this is getting a little stale after a few.
Yay!
Yeah.
Just doing that because actually to show some fast gameplay. Yeah. Different from normal, just.
Oh, this is pretty fast.
You really notice the imps fire all the time and stuff.
Yeah, this really makes a big difference. Like, every enemy react extremely fast, demons move ultra fast and stuff. It's not like normal enemies just idle half the time. Like, oh, I'm going to walk around. Oh.
They can't even. Are you lost
I don't
again?
Know, I didn't notice that much speed, but I guess so.
Well, if you try to chainsaw a fast demon, he bites you anyway.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, because he's too fast. He's
so that's a big difference.
Yeah, you recover very fast from his pain state and stuff.
Yeah.
You can see them attacking most of the time. Like, oh, this guy, I just opened the door and.
Haha!
Yeah, that's what Kukibo was thinking about. There's even the head throwing and stuff.
It's great.
Can you kick it around?
No. Pretty sad.
Aww.
That's an idea to update. I mean, maybe not this because there's no kicking. I mean, just punching. That's right, yeah. Yeah, you should maybe make the head punchable. That would be really funny.
Head ball! Go!
And there was problems. Let's
play some soccer with it.
Oh, yeah, actually, that's another idea. Just make soccer doom with zombie heads.
Yeah.
Why not? Everything can be made.
Why not?
To play soccer in the room.
Instead of saying stupid mini games and, you know, stuff like Turbo Shard Arcade or that other stupid ROMAC I played before, we could see actually fun stuff like, you know, Doom Soccer.
Yeah.
There's already Doom Ball.
Yeah. Yeah, that's decent.
Yeah, Doom
Except
Ball.
You can shoot the ball through the goal.
Oh, yeah, yeah. No.
I remember that, guys.
Yeah.
I had this long stalemate, and then I got the ball and was gonna score it, and then I threw it into the goal, and Nope. It just dropped.
So if you don't know, like, Doombar is like, you know that in Inner Tournament 2003, I believe, yeah, there was this game mode, bar game mode, and it was like, you know, rugby. You just have to take the bar and get it to the guard, so you can jump in the guard with the bar, that gets more points, and you can throw it away. Like, you have a can again to control the bar away. And this thing got ported to Doom, yeah, and it's very fun.
Pass it to a team, so stuff.
Yeah. Because Doom is very fast gameplay and stuff, so they made the mod and a bunch of maps for it, it's pretty fun.
Yeah, it lends very well to the Doom gameplay.
Yeah.
Oh, whoa! Dark Plant! Covered Combustion Warehouse, what?
Oh, ah, yeah, I like the random names as well for the things.
Yeah.
And everything is random. This time I won't be using AOD because this is already very long, 12 maps.
No, that would have been
the Yeah, but at least the maps aren't awful this time.
Yeah.
They're not too bad, and the fast gameplay is interesting.
Yeah.
I'm just waiting for Spain.
I mean, if you didn't camp so much.
Yeah.
Camping gameplay.
I'm the one that took the Pain Elemental slider always the fuck up.
Oh. Just a bunch of those.
Yeah. If you let the Pain Elemental just attack, fire at you for a bunch while you have like 30 lost souls everywhere and it gets really ugly.
I might have to retract my statement about the maps not being that bad then.
So there isn't a 19 soul limit for these Pain Elementals, is there? Because the original Doom had a 19 souls limit.
Oh yeah, actually yeah. So original Doom you could get
damn, he's fast!
Yeah, and that's the reason why I'm kinda camping when I see one, just because I don't want them to spam those souls, so I'm just waiting for them to get close.
Oh.
Yeah.
Talk about high birth rate.
Yeah.
That's why you don't want Pain Elementals for every infight with something else. Just keep spawning those things.
Man, they're also not too bad because they infight themselves with everything, including themselves, so it's not too bad, but yeah, it's still extremely annoying, especially on fast when they just keep attacking. They never stop attacking except when you shoot them. And like on normals, they just wander around, sometimes they charge at you, it's charge.
Yeah, at least they're most predictable
like,
now.
Like three of them just can kill you enough in a few seconds max. If you rush anything, can
you keep your distance?
Oh, there goes one.
Oh, and you can make a lot of sort of bugged in the air, like if it's flying and you shoot it once, it's going to go in a pin state and keep like flying away, like very slowly, and it won't move again until it hits a wall. Which can be very useful. When fighting.
They don't seem to fly much faster though, even though it's fast. It's
Only demons and specters go much faster.
Okay.
Because that's
well,
only enemies that
the projectiles of the imps and stuff go faster, so.
Yeah, too.
Maybe the attack should go faster too.
Well, we have.
They're already annoying
us. We don't know how fast he is.
Oh, yeah, we'll be seeing Archmage.
Oh.
That wouldn't be a big problem except 1 point. Much later.
Okay. Are you gonna do camping?
I mean, if with Ashrise, you have to get behind a wall if you want to die, just you know. And again, one more Pokemon.
Yeah. The Archrise, they don't have as faster attack now, they still have the same duration for their fire to explode.
Usually they just wander around like most of the time. And when they attack, you have like a few seconds to get away. Here, when they get you on side, attack you instantly, which can be very dramatic.
So, so they're not much different, are they?
No, except, you know, they keep attacking all the time. When they finish attacking, they attack right away. No more, they just... attack finishes, I move a bit. Oh, I'm going to walk there, left and right, and I'm not going to attack you, maybe. Or let's move a bit. Like, attack. Like, these imps still move a bit, but... if you look at, like, El Knights and Barons, they move less, I think. Revenants, too. You really see it with Revenants, like, when you have 10 fireballs throwing you, and there's, like, 2 Revenants. Oh yeah, and you see these pits everywhere. If you fall in one of them and you play with normal rules, that means no jumping. You die. because you can't get up. And some of them are just eight, so you can't jump out of them.
That's ouch.
Yeah, that's one reason why Oblige is kind of retarded. This pitch didn't exist, or at least I always have an exit, just like, you know, in Doom. Never Doom, so there was an exit to the stupid pits. At least I'm protector
of like Matt 3.
Oh, and again, like.
It's not top.
Yeah?
No, never mind.
Just mentioning that some.
I was just saying that there's not always a route out from pits in normal Doom either. There's a few ones that you can't get out of.
I think that's. Sometimes I can hit them. I think it's like an hidden elevator or something.
Teleporter, door.
Teleporter, door, elevator. Most of the times that's really something.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure on map 3, I think it is.
Doom 2?
Or map 4, the one with the secret exit to the secret level on the first episode of Doom 1.
Oh, Doom 1. Yeah. Man. Oh, yeah. Actually, I think you're right, yeah. That's pit,
there's two places. You can fall on the outside of that ring with the poison in and around it. Mm-hmm. And you can, at the start, you can just walk into the poison too.
Yeah, I think I remember dying that I was a kid a few times, so yeah.
Yeah, me too.
Go there, let's go there, so it was a secret.
Oh, that's why I remember it.
You got traumatized by this.
Well, we couldn't figure out how to fire the goddamn gun, so we had to use a joystick for shooting, and the people were moving. So we had two people to play Doom. It was still fun.
That's pretty good.
Yep. We didn't dare to touch any buttons to take the arrow keys, pretty much, and the space bar on the enter. So we were like, how do we do this? And then someone clicked on the joystick and oh yeah,
that worked.
This works.
Oh boy.
I got a bit of damage. Two few things that are kind of funny about these maps. First, this pack is kind of open, which is good. So you have, if you open the area with windows like this, you can see those areas. It's kind of neat for like a random generated map. Yeah. In one map, we'd be like up over the map and we'd be able to skip a bunch of stuff. We're not even jumping, but that's very later on the mod. And these rooms, you know, it's a few rooms keep spawning all the time, like previously I was going to talk, but that's not very important. And the last thing is the bars that was spaced, like, you see there was a space the same amount. Like the squares of bars, like in this room here, bars, very good spacing. I don't know, that's silly. Why couldn't be made?
Yeah, it should random it up a bit.
Yeah, that looks too like mechanical. Is that?
Well, UFC, you know, they're organized.
Yeah, organized. I mean, barrels.
That's why they put explosive barrels in your hallways.
Yeah, you gotta keep a distance between those barrels, Jimmy.
Yeah.
At least that there won't be a sort of chain reaction. Oh, good thinking.
Yeah, I guess.
I'd like to see chain reactions here.
Yeah, that's OSHU approved, I'm sure.
Oh, and these doors with the blue or red like thing on the sides means you have to use a switch to open them. Like there's a red door up here and was a blue one before.
Okay. Kind of like color doors, but with switches.
Yeah, I mean, it's have no purpose except, you know, instead of having to search for the key, you have to search for the switch. It's exactly the same.
Okay, just to confuse you.
Yeah, basically, yeah. But the switches, they are kind of obvious, Doom. Some mod maps were like, what the fuck did this switch do? Here it's like, red switch, red door.
Oh.
Which is a gun.
That's nice.
Yeah, it is. Well, that reminds me, like, of very early in the thread, like, after I actually started doing videos, I made a fast version of the first UTNT map.
Yeah.
Remember that, yeah?
I
think so.
I mean, you probably didn't watch it, Kitchener,
it was
but
a while
Sucker
ago.
Was there with me for commentating it, so...
Oh!
I guess I watched it then.
Yeah!
I think I watched it. That was a good friend of mine.
Yeah, don't worry about that. It's fine.
That blends together.
No, there's really a big bunch of videos to try. I think I should finish it at some point, but there's so much stuff like, oh, I should do this and this to run, oh, multi-process, this is neat. And oh, well, let's do this mod, I should just showcase, and oh, this mod pack is pretty nice, and fuck. You see that after one.
That is too much.
That's too much.
It's like trying to showcase the internet, it just keeps growing all the time, so you never.
Yeah, like with stuff updating and oh, is the Doom more updated? No, no, the Steam's the Doom Wars now. Like, the only thing I was missing was the Doom Wars. It exists now, so we can do team matches with the Doom Wars.
Oh.
Yeah. Well, that would be interesting.
Transfer Center, Jailbird. Oh, Berserk Pack.
Yeah, Berserk Pack.
But it's not very
Yeah,
useful.
It's not just you at all because me shoot so much and yeah.
Yeah.
It's really not a good idea to use.
It's sad.
Yeah, it's really sad. You see barrels everywhere and people shooting you, it's like, nope. No way.
Oh. Yeah. That was a nice aim.
Osho proved barrel placement.
And trying to shoot a Pegging Hunter with rockets not working at all and fast.
Yeah.
I have to snipe it.
Keeps pushing the souls out.
Yeah.
We are your fans! We want to make mods for you, Doom Guy! Let us in!
Damn it.
That's not stands. That's not lost souls. What are you thinking?
Oh, well, it's symbolic.
He's trying to murder you.
Nah, well, just want a big hug. Except I don't have no arms.
Yeah. I mean, they don't quite know how to give hugs.
Nice shotgun spreader.
Yeah, yeah, it's like three times an hour, like, no, god damn it, that's not possible. So when you use this weapon, you know you should be able to kill the Baron in the first hit, but sometimes, you know, you get fucked up by randomness.
Yeah.
One thing too about Fast, like the video of UTNT, like I was thinking about it because I remember like editing the code of different monsters to make them faster, like a few million monsters like the Satyrs. I had to add the flags in the code to make them like fast as the demons because they weren't. You see? Mm. Like demons have flags that causes like fast movement and fast melee. So they attack really, really fucking fast melee. And they move fast, as you can already see. And Satyrs and the Frozen melee only enemies didn't have that, so I had to add that manually.
To be honest, it's kind of hard to notice.
Yeah, because it's only because they die fast. It's obvious when you play it because you're like, oh yeah, I'm just going to dodge there. Oh, whoa, it was fast.
Yeah.
And
it
you just
is
keep
much
shooting.
Harder too.
Shooting like cacos, you can see cacos shooting a lot. It's not easier.
Wait, why the Nazi stuff here?
But the worst has a pain in the amount of shooting. And fuck you for this wad. It's not hard, but it's annoying. Well, I think that's kind of sad that we don't see any cyber demon at all. This.
Yeah, that would have been interesting.
Yeah, but since none got generated, I don't know if it took that zero or just the maps that didn't generate any. Or maybe they just generate one.
Can't play Worlds without my buddy Cyber Demon.
Yeah. But I'm not really missing him on Fast, it's really, really annoying to fight. Like, you have to hide behind walls every half a second. Or make a perfect secure trap, but it's not really easy when you have bars and walls everywhere.
Yeah.
I remember like doing a video of Air Revealed map 20 on Fast at some point.
Oh.
Yeah, I remember that it's American that said, oh hey, do that on Fast. Because, you know, there's no updates in the thread. I was one who tried to get updates for a very long time.
Sure, let's be Air Revealed on Fast, why not?
And yeah, there was a cyber...
Seems like a fun.
Two cyber demons in a very close space fight. And it took just forever. You have to just play peekaboo with shotguns.
Yeah,
this part is tricky because you have this archway up here. And oops, where do I hide? Oops. Oh, I think I'm picking up right now. No, I don't die. Oh, here I got very lucky.
It
turned around to attack one of the imps behind it.
Thankfully.
Thank you, imp. So I think that makes the game easier on Fast now, so it's in fighting. So it's very easy to play monster in fight. So things I fire.
Yeah, there's shooting
don't have
everywhere.
To. Sometimes you try to make current fight, and they just don't attack each other. Like, come on, just attack, just do something.
Yeah, just the guy in front shoots you with the shotgun, and the guy behind just keeps walking.
Yep. Here it's very easy to do that. Oops.
Oops. Yeah.
I stayed.
Haha. Shane gun good.
Oh, yeah, the mod has changed the sound of the chain gun look. Sounds better. Sounds more powerful.
That looks better too.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, it has a new sprite. Oh, and you could skip a bunch of the level if you just jump over this fence here, but I'm not supposed to do that.
Yeah.
I jump sometimes.
It's even more if you snow pit the exit.
Yeah, sure. You snow.
Type map 12 and
yeah.
Yeah.
I wouldn't be no legitimate. I have no problem doing that on shitty like Doom Axe and Doom joke wise, but here it means something normal.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This map seems sensible at least.
Yes.
It's just hundreds of barons and archers behind them.
Oh boy.
And you have a plasma rifle.
Heck, yeah. Oh, it reminds me of Eve's Dot, where I like so much stuff cramped into maps. I'm more like having like almost 1,000 enemies, or at least 400 or something like that. That's pretty insane.
Yeah.
But very glorious when played with air. Like, oh hey, there's so much different enemy types in our fights. They just grab popcorn and wait until they die. Come back here. Oh hey, I have 10,000 weapons dropped in the ground. Peekaboo. Hey, Ashfry, what's up?
Peekaboo.
There's actually a tree that got posted in.
See, this is.
Yeah?
No. It was a bad joke.
No.
I missed the opportunity now.
Damn. That was a problem.
I've always been wondering, why doesn't the AK now have a melee attack? Because he's got hands, and, the other guy doesn't.
That's actually a. Good thing, yeah, because let me talk about this video related because it's related. So, like, there's a video got posted in 2D5 SPS thread. Like, it's a guy make a video on YouTube, looks retarded, but he got actually good tips. And the first one is like, yeah, you can go in melee with pen elementals and they can attack you.
Oh, that video.
Yeah, and that got changed. In Ardoom, Ardoom is a mod that changes enemies, make them much harder. Hit points, attacks. Stuff like cyber demons fires homing rockets. Oh, that's horrible.
Oh,
and so pain motors get some melee attack. So, yeah, you can't do this trick on him anymore, which makes them much harder to beat. You just can't go to melee.
Yeah,
right. Okay, so basically, the cyber demon is like the cyber demon in Doom 64.
Even because he has two rocket launchers,
yes.
And
two rocket launchers.
And if they're homing rockets, and they're homing very, very fast. It's not like you can't outrun them. So faster than
Wow.
And they got nerfed. They was even better before. It's really tricky. You can't just secure strafe him.
Well, how do you solve it?
Which is good. You can secure strafe as a cyber demon now. It's not possible.
Yeah. Sounds very tricky.
You have to hide Ben most of the time and even that's rockets. It's like Robin shot, but 10 times worse.
Yeah.
Well,
it always happens one hit if you're unlucky.
Yes.
Yeah. And he fires them. He still fires them in like 603, so he fires 6. Yeah, it's a thing. Oh, yeah, just finishing the video. And one of the tricks that was interesting is like against Ashrise, if you have a wall in front of you, which is still low enough that the Ashrai can see you and you're hugging it, you only take 20 damage from the Ashrai.
Oh! Yeah.
Because like...
The splash gets absorbed by the wall.
Yeah, the splash attack is like projectile, I guess, and it gets absorbed by the wall in front of you and you only take the direct damage, which is 20.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I mean,
there's not that many opportunities you get to do that.
Yeah, I never.
This is really just not better to hide behind a wall and block the attack entirely.
Yes. And you can use like melee attacks of revenants and demons too. If you just something I very very often with demons, when I see one, I just run to them and go back. So they attack and they don't move, so they don't they can't like surround me or get closer or whatever, block my way.
Yeah, and since the attack happens at the end of the animation,
yeah,
you can move away before they finish.
And sorry, even on fast, you can do that. It's harder, but still very easy. And revenants can do that too, but sometimes you have to do that, but stay very close. If you go for a bit farther, they will fire a rocket instead of attacking melee. But
yeah, it's kind of annoying to have revenants.
Yeah, it's kind of tricky and wonderful.
The rock is hurt too, and you can't really dodge them if you try and get close again for the swing.
Yes.
So you just run into the rocket and take a bunch of damage.
But I think it can be done if you stay really close and you just dodge at the last moment of his attacks and you keep in melee the rest of the time.
Yeah.
So he never fires rockets.
One question about revenants, is it possible to kill them with their own rockets?
No.
Okay.
Yeah, monsters are usually immune to their own attack. Imps can't kill other imps. And barons can kill other barons. And same for the remnants, are immune to their own damage. So if you try doing that, it's not going to do anything.
Yeah. Yeah, but they don't try and fight each other.
No. Only zombies and. Zombies attack each other.
Yeah,
Lossurus, of course.
Lossurus.
Ashflies and Nurs, I can't attack each other because I'm pretty annoying because this Spaniamotor just stings way the fuck back and I have no more like actually that pistol
bullets.
Chain bullets, yeah, it's like very back and they do something else.
That's annoying.
Banshee
Quantum Barrels. If you move fast enough back you don't take any damage.
Yeah, that's possible. Sometimes fail and take like 80 damage.
Yeah, it kind of hurts, but it's Doom's version of Russian Roulette.
Yeah.
Doom guy barrel.
Doom guy barrels. Damn. That will make a fun mini game.
Yeah.
Too much barrels you can kill in melee with a tank. We're all talking about targeting and Ashfries are kinda weird because they can't be targeted. But they can kill each other themselves with their aura attacks. Which you know aura. So aura splash effect is most of the damage.
Yeah.
And you can make an Ashfry kill a cyber demon if you want. The cyber demon shoots Ashfry in the back and you go hide and you go take a coffee and some tea, go eating, go back and maybe cyber demon's going to die. Because he won't attack a attack. Because you can't target the Ashfry. It's kinda cheap, but I've seen one map was very, really bad and
someone's being fair and square.
I don't want to overdo this map right now. It's not worth it. It's already long enough as it is.
Yeah.
And now we're gonna throw this one
stop
go,
the
so...
now.
Yeah. Oh, still not try. Jout. I kinda like this placement because the exit is right there up here with the Ashfry. And it's in view.
It's just taunting you.
Yeah, I always like when you have the next part of the level, the secrets or the exit just being there for you to see. So you can like show up.
At least don't figure out how to get up there. I don't know where it is.
Oh, so that's a bed with secrets. Oh yeah, I see this mega sphere up here. How do I get there? I know it's there, so I must just keep looking.
Yeah, you spend 50 minutes looking for it. But...
yeah, but sometimes it can be very well done on maps. If you just have auras, you can see it. You get later on, and you get on this aura, it's like up here, and you see where you were before with a lot of corpses and stuff, and it looks really neat.